GTA works, I'm also going to fucking drop it after the first few episodes just because I am flat sick of the fucking mecha genre. Unless it does something halfway different than most of the hundreds and hundreds of fucking anime featuring the mecha theme does out there, I'm probably going to hate it. But since this is done by PA Works, I stuck with it. But I was at first really disappointed that they turned away from what they were good at. I saw this as a really bad sign at first. I felt like they were finally at the mercy of Japan's mech craze and were suddenly just bowing down in defeat to it. But then, as the story went on and more stuff started to become known and pop up, and all the plot points finally came together. And while, yes, there are some things I still hate, the issues though are few. Though human filth, I'm the English Animus Freak. And I bring you a review of PA Works' 50th anniversary project, Koru Koru. Don't get me wrong, I'm still fucking sick of the mecha genre, but asking the Japanese to get rid of it would be like telling us to get rid of fucking Star Wars or some shit. Popular culture over there in Japan practically grew up with this shit. What I'm asking for is to do something new with it. Nice Estonia did it correctly by laying out high-yield science fiction themes and basing its mecha on real-world science. And while Koru Koru pales in comparison to that, the twist here is still a lot better than most. And that's fucking aliens. Yes, I know that it might sound superficial, but the whole invaders from another world thing is sorely lacking in anime. And I know, like, some of you may think that, you know, there are some alien invasion animes out there, but most of the time aliens and mecha animes, or animes in general, but we'll figure there are either interdimensional enemies or just flat stupid looking humanoids with cat ears or some shit. Now, granted, yes, the invading aliens look pretty much human, but there's one alien, just one in particular, who actually looks fucking alien. But anyways, the story. So, 450 years prior to the story's beginning in fucking Sengoku era Japan, the Washima clan is suddenly attacked by an alien force called Epidome. And since these were ancient Japanese samurai we're talking about, they weren't capable of understanding the whole anything sciencey thing. They just labeled them as demons. And during the skirmish, the prince of the clan and one of her loyal servant samurais, Kinosuke, fight back in one of the enemy's stolen mechas, which they dub the Black Relic, or in Japanese, Koromakuru. They succeed in pushing back the initial invasion, but the relic is caught in an explosion and they both disappear. We then cut to the present day, 2016, where the Black Relic has been dug up during the construction of a dam, and the United Nations begins studying it. It enters the daughter of the UN director and our main character, Yukina Shiramaru, who pays her mom a visit on the day Epidote suddenly returned to finish what they started. And in all the bullshit, Yukina accidentally triggers the relic, releasing Kinosuke from cryostasis, and hasn't helped with cutting off the initial attack. But since the Black Relic can only be operated by the two of them, for ancient ancestry reasons, basically, they both become assets of the military and are both thrust into the role of defending the Earth from the alien threat. So, while this is mecha, there are some rather compelling things here. Lots of science fiction going on that, granted, doesn't always make a lot of sense, but most of the time it's pretty cool. And the fact that Kinosuke is from the Sengoku era, of course, and of course making it suddenly have adjusted to the fucking 21st century, and this leads to some pretty fucking humor scenes.
それのどこに?
どうにも落ち着かん。ゆえに。
Share screen time, and not a single one is fucking forgotten. Some of them were kind of annoying, like Tom Burden, who's basically a fucking US Army soldier in charge of a pilot that fights in standard little mecha called GAS, or Gravity Attenuated Upright Shells, as this anime calls them. And he just so happens to hang out in Inosuke for, I don't know, manly reasons, I guess? I don't fucking know. Which was honestly disappointing. The only fucking American in the cast just happens to be a fucking muscle-bound asshole. Pretty typical of an American soldier, I guess, but... They just can never be pleasant people, let's face it. But anyways, moving on, while we're talking about these gravity attenuated upright shells, they just happen to be developed by Ethan's mother, who's one of those devoted mommy types, but has absolutely no idea how to be one. Kind of like most mothers nowadays, if you ask me. They have kids, but don't have the knowledge or the fucking money to fucking raise them. And Ethan's mother spends most of the time in the anime worrying about her daughter, but also knows that deep down she's still going to make her own decisions. Which I wish all mothers could do with their kids, at least past a certain age, but whatever. Then there's Sophie's French exchange student, who just so happens to be a fucking samurai freak. And of course, test pilot for the GAS. And we got fucking butler Toshiyuki Kazumi, or Sebastian as she likes to call him, who also just so happens to be a fucking JSDF captain, and man, is he devoted to her. Speaking of devotion, there's also the university series fucking overly devoted school counselor who takes her job way too seriously. Almost to the point of stalking would-be students who might lose their fucking path, and practically jumps in fucking Kinosuke when he suddenly looks unsure of what to do in regards to his feelings for fucking Yukina. And of course, we can't forget that Yukina is a high school student, so she has a few high school friends here as well, but there's her longtime friend, Marina Yunagi, who always has her ear when things get tough for her, as well as Junmei Paihara, who's always seen with a camera videotaping shit, streaming shit on the internet, and especially like this place's last few episodes. This kid doesn't give a fuck as long as there's fucking scoop to be made and views to be earned. And there's of course fucking Roy Kagi, who has a thing for Yukina, but of course is caught up with Kinosuke and does a whole lot of fucking half-assed things trying to get attention, but ultimately fails to make it hard to keep metal down the process. And then finally, there is of course my personal favorite character, the alien Zuru. I don't know. But it's just because he's both an alien and the only one in the anime who actually looks fucking alien. An alien that all looks demonic, having red skin and horns at all, that's for the reason why Kinosuke didn't trust him at first. But I was fucking ecstatic at this. I, being hardcore sci-fi nerd I am, was thrilled to see an actual fucking alien in anime. And there are a number of other characters here that if I went into would take up literally an hour of fucking time. And since neither of us wants to hear me talk for that long, I'm just gonna make the basic bottom line point. The cast is rich, fun, and fucking diverse as fuck. The works are matches doing characters correctly, making them believable, fleshed out, and fucking overall fun. Their characters often feel more down-to-earth than those other characters, and a single one is never forgotten by the end. And it's sad you're never going to see them again when the anime ends. I felt the same way with Kunan. I felt the same way with Kasaku Aurora. I felt it with True Tears, and I share some fucking Angel Beats, despite the fact I and others felt it with Rush a bit. But speaking of saying goodbye, this brings me to the anime's biggest flaw. The fucking ending. And that's a very debatable term, so it has absolutely no fucking ending whatsoever. But yes, it does quote-unquote ends at the worst possible time with very little resolution other than the battle won. It ends literally, right when they were finally going into space to combat the enemy head-on. In other words, you know, space exploration? Another thing that anime doesn't do enough of fucking today, at all. And this is the anime's biggest fucking disappointment. This leaves gigantic room for a type of continuation. Fucking second season, a movie, or hell, even a fucking novel or some shit. It needs some type of continuation, and it needs it desperately. Yet, there's no sign of one. No sign of one whatsoever. At least as of this review, no movie, no nothing has been announced. And it's infuriating as fuck. Right when they were actually doing something that I wanted them to actually do throughout the entire fucking series, it just fucking ends. Prematurely and leaving the face of the main characters completely up in the fucking air. There was nothing good about it. Now, animation-wise, this is my fucking PA motherfucking works. Do I honestly need to say anything more than that? These guys are fucking brilliant. They made a vast number of my all-time fucking favorites. All of which match has been highly fucking acclaimed by not just me, but a lot of other people as well. If you don't know who they are, then you clearly don't watch the fucking anime. You can tell it's better than just by looking at how the anime just looks. Until, of course, you get into the mecha. You see, this anime does take after the real robot game that Sidonia had. That's what made, and what made me fucking just sell it for me. Real robot, if you don't know, is a subgenre of mecha that uses real science and physics for the robots. And yes, and you know, yes, I'm gonna admit it, after watching Next Sidonia, I pretty much hold that particular anime as a standard to which I pretty much judge all fucking mecha anime. So if you don't like that whole fact about me, and you kind of enjoy mecha, then you're probably gonna hate my fucking channel and blog, so you might wanna just, you know, take your shit somewhere else. But the real life business that KOS had just aren't fucking here. The mecha moves far too human-like, and yes, the Black Relic and the Epidome Mecha are alien technologies should be more advanced than us humans, but still, it also happens with the fucking human made Guts. And you also have to understand that, again, this story takes place in 2016. They shouldn't have this little fucking tech. So there are a lot of weird-ass plot holes here that coincide with the animation. And I guess you can argue it away by saying this is an alternate version of Earth. I mean, there is some pretty impressive tech in the UN facilities, but I still saw little to no evidence to suggest that this is a alternate history. Is this a mega here done here to physics? Or at least physics of that age? And yeah, I know what you're fucking thinking, and I agree. This is anime, okay? This is fucking anime. It's not supposed to make sense. Most of the time, it just fucking shits things like physics and logic out of its fucking ass and plays it the rule of cool. You know, you just have to accept it or ignore it if you want to enjoy it. Aside from the mecha fighting, though, there's also a few rather good sword fights done rather well. After all, Kinosuke is a samurai. And even though studios are always changing shit up, changing directors and character designers for different shit, which does make research a goddamn nightmare, I'll admit, but everyone who worked on this is a fucking genius. We have Tensai Okamura as the fucking director, also directing both seasons of fucking Darker Than Black, and fucking Yuriko Ishii as chief animation director, who not only worked on pretty much every other fucking game work, but also on the Ghost in the Shell Solid State Society movie, and also Soul Eater. So, my god, was there a fucking team behind this. All of these were fan favorites, and both of these people, along with everyone else, deserve every fucking bit of praise they got, and every bit of notoriety they're getting. When all is said and done, this is an anime that tells a good story and has an awesome array of characters. The mecha doesn't make a lot of sense, though. But that can be considered a minor technicality, I guess. But for the ending, there's literally no excuse or technicality that can fucking argue this shit away. It's fucking shitty. It was just all around fucking bad. It was horrible. But I guess despite that, I can't bring myself to hate this. I just can't. In the end, the stories about aliens invading Earth is cool. The cast of memorable characters is awesome. I loved it all. And therefore, the final recording of Kurumakoro is a good 8 out of 10. It's another awesome step forward for PA Works. Well, I hope to God there's some kind of continuation to make up this god-awful ending. I still look forward to my PA Works next. Because this is a fucking studio you almost can never fucking go wrong with. And with that, I'm fucking done. If you enjoyed this video, at the very least find my video unstoppable or downright stupid and want to subscribe, do not do it on YouTube. Subscribe to my blog because I don't trust YouTube this shit. And until next time, film you and film, I'm the angry septic freak. And I just don't give a fuck.
I am the Shadow Warrior, dying at times here.